Hey guys, Danny here from Horror Dads with
Charlotte,
the Horror Daughter, and there's a lot of noise going on outside, but bigger news is happening here on YouTube where the Ghostbusters Afterlife final trailer is out. Finally, we are going to get a chance to see this movie coming up later this year. It was supposed to come out last year, but of course, like most everything, it was postponed for the pandemic. I'm a little excited. What about you? Are you
excited?
Charlotte saw the first movie. What did you think of the first movie?
I thought it was good. My favorite part was when they were fighting Marshmallow Fluff Man.
Marshmallow Fluff Man? The Stay Puft Marshmallow Man, yes. Which is an all-time classic ending.
I did get scared at the library.
Everyone gets scared at the library. That's what makes Ghostbusters such an integral gateway horror film, is that for as hilariously funny as it is, and it is one of the greatest comedies of all time, it's also a pretty scary movie, especially if you're my age.
Ghostbusters is the one that has the girl from Aliens.
Yes, it's the one with the girl from Aliens.
See,
in it.
See, I do remember stuff.
Yes, you do. Good. Yes. I almost just said yes, the actress Ellen Ripley. No, Sigourney Weaver plays Dana Barrett. She was Ellen Ripley in Alien and Aliens and Alien 3. You saw that too, right?
No, I didn't.
You never saw Alien 3?
No!
Oh, that's all right. You don't need Alien 3. But anyway, we're going to do a live reaction. She has not seen the Ghostbusters Afterlife trailer. I only watched it once on my phone earlier today, so we're going to check it out. You check it out with us, and then we'll just talk about it a little bit at the end. By the way, Pete, the other horror dad, him and his daughter Pepper are going to be covering this trailer on his other channel, Comic Books Transformed. So after you watch this video, you can head over there later today and check out their video as well. So let's take a look at this trailer.
Great mom.
I don't know. I'm fine with Trevor. But with Phoebe, she really keeps me on the outside.
That's normal.
Paul Rudd.
She's an awkward,
never ages
kid.
Maybe a new home could be an opportunity to start fresh. I just wish you'd get into some trouble.
There's still time.
Don't look in the trap, Ray.
What are you doing here in Somerville anyway?
We're completely broke.
I don't know who that is.
This creepy old farmhouse in the middle of nowhere.
Your father wasn't much of a homemaker. He could hardly keep the power on.
You remember? That's the secretary.
I wouldn't say
Jeanine from Ghostbusters.
Oh, right.
You went with the station wagon?
It's the only one that had an engine.
That is the son of the original movie's director, Jason Reitman. His father.
Shush, let me watch the trailer.
The town with no fault lines is shaking on a daily basis.
Maybe it's the apocalypse. We've gone through that here for a reason.
Are you troubled by strange noises in the middle of the night?
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
You or any of your family ever seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
Aww.
Oh my god.
You guys hear that?
Something's coming.
A whole city.
It's the Walking Dead.
Whoa. It looks a little Goosebumps, doesn't it? Although, that was one of Zool's dog noises. So,
oh my god.
Yeah. I have a lot of thoughts. What did you think?
I have too much stuff to say.
Well, what was your... Does it look good?
Yes.
So, first of all, who did you recognize in there?
Finn Wolfhard. I'm not sure. Who is at the end?
I think, if I could recognize... I thought that was Bill Murray's voice at the end. It's either Bill Murray's voice or Dan Aykroyd's voice. I thought it was Bill Murray's voice saying we're closed. Yeah. who played Venkman.
Venkman.
So, obviously, this is taking place at Egon's family's house, and these kids and the mom are Egon's family. But my only issue is, considering that an original Ghostbuster was their family member, there doesn't seem to be a lot of knowledge of the Ghostbusters. It seems like they have to research on the internet who the Ghostbusters are. And it's like, if your dad or if your grandfather was Egon Spengler, all this information would be out there about the Ghostbusters. So, yeah. That to me is a little... I hope that that's just like a trailer thing and that they clear that up in the movie. But almost everything else looks really, really good in here. Obviously, where do you know Finn Wolfhard from?
I know him from seven movies.
From, okay. Oh, well. So, yeah, well.
He's from It. He plays Richie. He plays Mike from Stranger Things.
Yep, and Charlotte just binged all three seasons of Stranger Things. And we're going to be talking about Stranger Things later this year on the channel. Later this summer, actually, as we prep for season 4 coming up.
Yeah.
I love that they brought Annie Potts back. She plays Janine. And, you know, obviously, so I don't know if you know this, but Harold Ramis, the actor who plays Egon, he died several years ago. Mm-hmm. But the fact that they're using him makes me very happy, because he was kind of like the unspoken heart. You know, him and Ray were really the heart and soul of the Ghostbusters. It was their grand scheme. Obviously, Winston was brought on later, and Venkman was just kind of the tag-along, you know, fun friend.
Winston was
yeah.
The one who came, like, after?
Yeah.
Oh, so it was the three guys and then Winston.
And then Winston joins up later. Yeah.
Winston's like, hi, guys.
And Winston was always one of my favorites, too. I hope we get an Ernie Hudson cameo in this movie.
The guy with the glasses. I forgot his name.
Well, there's Bill Murray and Dan Aykroyd who play Peter and Ray. But I think I first of all, Paul Rudd makes everything better. So that's going to be a lot of fun to see him kind of step into the lead. I love the sidecar of Ecto-1. You saw it with the girl like sitting out in the side. I thought that was awesome. What did you think about the little Stay Puft Marshmallows in the store?
I was like, I don't know if you guys heard me, but I was like, aww. Like a confused aww.
Yeah, I have a feeling that that is going to appeal to people your age a lot more than it appeals to old fogies like me. Because when I saw that, I went, oh no.
There's going to be giant Stay Puft Marshmallows in 2 years.
Yeah. I mean, again, I'm thinking that that's just kind of like a good trailer moment to get in. Because like I said at the beginning, Ghostbusters was a gateway horror movie. Yes, that opening library scene is scary. The rest of the movie is hilariously funny. But it also deals with ghosts and the undead. And, you know, the whole nature of Ghostbusters is horror to begin with, even though it's played mostly for comedy. I do hope that this movie is a lot funnier than it appears in the trailer. Charlotte just fell off screen. Because it doesn't look too funny, right?
It doesn't. I really saw no laughs and no hilariousness.
This movie looks like it's like kind of kids melodrama about like kids who are struggling to fit in this, you know, farming community, small town America.
You taught me to shush during trailers. And
well, I was reacting to it. And then the action starts, and it doesn't, I'm hoping with Paul Rudd and then the cameos that we're going to get from the cast members from the original, I'm hoping that it's a lot. I'm hoping the hilariousness comes through, because this didn't seem, overall, if you were going to gauge your excitement level on a scale of 1 to 10, what would you say? How excited are you for Ghostbusters Afterlife? 8.5? I think you're a little bit more than me. I would say probably a 7.
I was going to say 7, but I didn't want
to
burst
through. I'm going to see it. I'm looking forward to parts of it. I do have some questions. I do have some issues. I think I'm getting optimistic. So you could check out Pete and Pepper's video on comic books transformed later on. We have some videos covering Comic-Con at home up on the channel now. Charlotte and I talked about the upcoming Chucky series, and we are going to be covering Army of Darkness very soon, and talking about the Evil Dead trilogy. And then Stranger Things and some other cool stuff coming up.
We have so much stuff.
I know. So much
Wait.
Stuff. What?
Before we all leave, Daddy, we're going to call
Ghostbusters!